Hello, in this series of videos, I'm going to go over a couple of examples, simple examples of voltage regulators. Now I'm going to focus on linear regulators as opposed to switching regulators. And I'll do a few examples on shunt regulators and series regulators. Now, shunt regulators, these are regulators where the regulating circuit, the regulating device, is placed in parallel with the load, and they are typically easier to design, but they are less efficient than the series regulators, where the regulating circuit is placed in series with the load. Now, if efficiency is not that important, then you can just go with a shunt regulator. So let's do a couple of examples here. In a previous video, when we were covering power supplies and diode applications, I already went over the Zener regulator. So in this circuit, in the Zener regulator circuit, let's do some analysis. You have an unregulated input. So you have an unregulated input. And we are trying to create a regulated output. So this is our input. We are putting a regulated output by placing the Zener, which is the regulating device in this case, in parallel, shunt, with the load. And the way this circuit works is that as long as I have enough Zener current, enough current going through the Zener, to make sure that the Zener is in the reverse breakdown region, voltage Zener, changes then in current are going to give approximately the same output voltage, the Zener voltage. Now this is easy to design if we want a voltage output at any voltage particular that you want. You choose the Zener voltage. You can also put diodes in series to achieve that output voltage. And then we just need to choose the biasing resistor to make sure that we are providing IS is equal to the load current plus the Zener current. This is going to be typically relatively small, but we need to provide a little bit of Zener current to make sure that we are reverse biased it. So what is the output voltage? The output voltage is equal to the Zener voltage. The output current is going to be the output over the resistance, meaning the Zener voltage over the load resistance. As I mentioned, the IS, the biasing current that we have here, needs to be equal to the Zener current plus the load current, and or you can say the Zener current is going to be IS minus the load and should be higher than the current, the reverse current in the Zener in order for it to achieve the Zener breakdown. And so the design is simple. We have an unregulated input. We know what the V output is, which is the V Zener here. And we just choose RS to make sure that we provide the load current as well as bias the Zener. In the next video, I'm going to go over a couple of other examples.